and allow our translators to come on and share a little bit about what considerations might be necessary. So please come on and, you know.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Erika Perez, and I have my colleague Kelly Palacios, who will be interpreting today. We appreciate Cooperative Fund of New England for taking language justice into consideration. So right now at the bottom of your screen, you will see a little glove. If you're on your computer, click on that little glove and then choose English. You should be all set. If you're joining from your cell phone, there's three little dots on the bottom of the right side. It says more, tap there. And also try to find the little glove which says language interpretation, tap on that. And you will see English and Spanish. Choose English and then make sure to press done. And also for the panelists, just a reminder to please not speak too fast and also one mic at a time. And I will have my video off, but if in any given minute, I'll see if somebody's speaking fast, I'll turn my video on and I'll use this sign. So if everyone can help me with that. Okay, buenas tardes a todos. Mi nombre es Erika Pérez y tengo a mi colega Kelly Palacios. Ella y yo vamos a estar interpretando el día de hoy. Le queremos agradecer a la Cooperativa de Fondos de Nueva Inglaterra, que ellos están comprometidos con la justicia de los idiomas. Entonces, ya está activada la interpretación. En la parte de abajo van a ver un icono que parece como un globito. Presionen ahí y escojan español y listo. Si están llamando desde su celular, hay tres puntitos en la parte de abajo, en el lado derecho, presionen ahí y luego busquen el globito también donde dice interpretación de idioma y luego escojan español y presionen finalizado o done. Y solo estaba recordándoles también de que cuando van a estar hablando los panelistas que no hablen tan rápido y si en algún momento van a estar hablando muy rápido, voy a encender mi pantalla y hacer esta señal. Que hablen un poco más lento y este también que solo una persona a la vez. Thank you, all set.
All right, thank you so much for everyone, to everyone for being here. As I mentioned earlier, we're diving into cooperative principles 6 and 7 today. And today we hope to review the principles a little bit before we get started. And then we'll hop on to our panel discussion where you'll hear from the folks who we've gathered to share some of their experiences. And our learning objectives today are to understand why intercooperation and community engagement are core principles of the cooperative movement. And we want to learn from our peers about how this intercooperation and community engagement can be successful or how we can amplify the impact of our work through leveraging these principles. And we want to identify key challenges to address your own implementation. So those are some of our objectives today. If you have any questions, you can drop them in the chat. And as we go on, we may be able to address them or we'll address it all at the end. We should be having a bit of fun today. So I encourage you to, you know, stay active, ask your questions, and we'll keep trying to make the conversation as relevant as we can. I want to invite on my colleague, Carolyn, to give a little overview of the Cooperative Fund of New England.
Hey, everybody. Welcome again, and thank you for being here. So CFNE is a nonprofit community loan fund. We've been around since 1975. We were founded to fund food co-ops, but because co-ops and community-owned organizations tend to be hard for banks to understand and weird to get funding for, we now provide funding for all types of co-ops, worker, consumer, shared services, land trust, etc. We both provide financial products that work well for co-ops, and then also provide training and technical assistance and support. So workshops like this are part of that mission to make it possible for people throughout the New East, the Northeast, to fund and found co-ops.
Excellent. Now, we like to begin at the beginning. And so for anyone who's new to the cooperative movement or to this workshop about cooperative and the principles, just going to give a brief overview of what is a cooperative and some of the principles. So a cooperative is an autonomous association of persons united voluntarily to meet their common needs and aspirations through a jointly owned and democratically controlled enterprise, right? It's a business owned, operated, and benefiting the people who use its services. So that's where we are, that's what we're interested in, and we're hoping to use this enterprise, this vehicle, to create change in our communities. As we're engaging in cooperative enterprise, there are some principles established internationally that we can all draw inspiration from. And throughout the year, we've held workshops on many of these principles. In fact, this is our last workshop of the year covering these last two principles, 6 and 7. And, you know, it's been a fun time. You can access the recordings from these workshops on our YouTube channel if you want to get caught up into any of the ones that we've done in the past. So what are the principles? Principle 6, cooperation among cooperatives. The principle is illustrated here through these three different ideas of how co-ops can work together, right? The principle says cooperatives serve their members most effectively and strengthen the cooperative movement by working together through local, national, region, and international structures. And when we think of these structures, we're thinking of informal project-based engagements like a collaboration or a transaction. We're thinking of a network, a loosely decentralized association of folks with shared interests. Or we're thinking of a federation, something centralized and formal, representing a group of cooperatives who share an interest and, you know, want to advocate or achieve something together. So we're really thinking of a broad configuration of structures that can help cooperatives accomplish their goal. When we're thinking of principle 7, we're thinking of concern for community. And it says, cooperatives work for the sustainable development of their communities through policies approved by their members. And so the key term there is sustainable development. And so this framework could be local, or it could be, you know, much broader than that. And it always concerns people, planet, profit. And, you know, there's so many dimensions to this one. You're thinking of engaging the work we're doing so that it's sustainable for today and tomorrow, as well as these three dimensions. So we so much to talk about in both of these. And we're going to invite on our panelists to share about how these principles come alive in their work